You can tell a lot about a person just from their hair. Like, I can look at you and know if you're bald just like that. Hi everyone, Julian here for DNews from YouTube Space LA. A person's hair reveals a lot of secrets about them, and you can uncover them not by interpreting clumps of human hair with pilomancy or some other form of heresy, but with science. I'm going to wager you've seen the detective shows where they find a single hair at the crime scene, extract the DNA from it, find the murderer, and then David Caruso puts on his sunglasses and says something like, "He almost got away with it, but was just a hair short." It's true that hair can be used to pull a DNA sample, but it's a lot harder than those shows make it seem. See, most of your hair is dead cells. When they die, they're pressed together to form a protein called keratin, and new cells are generated underneath them by the root. In the process, though, the nucleus inside the cell gets destroyed, and the DNA goes with it. So usually, to get their hair sample with any useful DNA, it has to have a root attached. Rarely some DNA will survive cornification, but finding hair at a crime scene is not the smoking gun it's always made out to be. Incomplete hair may help determine maternal lineage, though. Because mitochondrial DNA is passed from mother to offspring and is thousands of times more abundant than nuclear DNA, it's easier to get a sample to analyze. But even without the root, hair can be full of secrets. Keratin has sulfur atoms that bond to trace elements, which explains why trace is so hairy. Anyway, these elements can give away what you've been putting in your body. I know a lot of you immediately thought about drugs, and it's true. Drug tests can find out if someone's been using marijuana or opiates or amphetamines or PCP. And since those elements bind to your hair when the hair is forming, the longer your hair, the farther back the test goes. So if you're a hippie with dreads finally applying for that big government job, there's another reason to get a haircut. Don't think shaving your head bald will help either, because your hair is everywhere, screaming infidelities. Like your body hair. Drug tests can use that too. And since body hair doesn't grow like the hair on your head, it could actually represent a longer time frame, possibly up to a year, though there are no conclusive studies on that. Either way though, it hurts your chances of passing a drug test if you're a hairy pothead. Interestingly though, it takes about 5 to 7 days for forming hair to start protruding past the scalp. So you could do a bunch of drugs and pass a hair drug test that same day. But, you know, don't do a bunch of drugs, please. Keratin's tendency to grab trace elements can be used to divine more mundane things, too, like it can tell us what someone's diet is. The fact makes it useful for studying animals, like bears. Researchers have actually developed a new technique that runs a laser down the length of a single bear hair and vaporizes it. The gas is then analyzed by a mass spectrometer. The old method involved analyzing bunches of hair, which gave them a general idea of what they had been eating. Doing it this way lets them easily tell exactly when their diets change and monitor how much mercury they're getting from fish. Plus, I imagine it's safer running up and plucking one hair from a grizzly than grabbing entire handfuls. So the eternal question still stands. Does she or doesn't she dye her hair? Only her hairdresser knows for sure. Unless it's blue, then we can all tell, because blue almost never happens in nature. Trace explains why here.
Blue is a tough color. Yeah, the sky appears to be blue and water appears to be blue, even though they're not actually. Though some birds, plants, and butterflies do display the color blue, it's actually a super rare color in nature.
Do you have any hair-raising questions? Let us know in the comments or Facebook or Twitter or our subreddit r/DNews. Subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time on DNews.